गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडेज लेसन क्लाइमेट ऑफ इंडिया. बिफोर गोइंग टू द लेसन लेट मी आस्क सम जनरल नॉलेज क्वेश्चंस. ओके चिल्ड्रन, फर्स्ट वन इज विच इज द लार्जेस्ट कॉफी प्रोड्यूसिंग स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया. Which is the largest coffee producing state of India? The answer is Karnataka. Second one, in which state is the main language Kasi? I will repeat the question. In which state is the main language Kasi? The answer is Meghalaya. Next, third question, what is the state flower of Haryana? Answer is lotus. Fourth one is which state has the largest area? The answer is Rajasthan. Fifth one is which state has the largest population? Which state has the largest population? The answer is Uttar Pradesh. Okay, now we'll go for the lesson. Today's topic is climate of India. See here, natural environment. The natural environment of any country can be classified into land and landforms. That water, that is rivers and sea and climate. See land and landforms. Rivers and sea. See here. The natural environment of any country can be classified into land and landforms, water, that is rivers and sea, and climate, that is climate. Now, climate of India. Here we are going to learn about the climate of India. We have to know climate and weather. What is the difference between climate and weather? Let us know. The state of atmospheric conditions over an area at any point of time refers to weather. Weather conditions keep fluctuating always. Right? Weather conditions keep fluctuating always. Variations of weather. Climate is the variation of weather in a region over long period of time. Now, temperature. The elements of weather and climate are atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity, precipitation. elements of weather and climate are atmospheric pressure, wind, humidity and precipitation. See here, the pattern of these elements for a place can be shown using pictures called chirographic or climatographs. See, climatographs show average monthly values of maximum temperature, minimum temperature and rainfall for a given place. Climatographs show average monthly values of maximum temperature, minimum temperature and rainfall for a given place. See, climate diagram. This diagram will show the temperature and rainfall. Next, we'll go for climatographs of a few places in India. The climatographs show that temperature and rainfall vary in different parts of the country. See here, for example, in Jaipur, -40 degrees maximum temperature during the year and minimum temperature 5 degrees centigrade. Rainfall July to August 210 millimeters. And name driest month December. In Jammu and Kashmir, place Leh, maximum temperature 30 degrees and minimum temperature 0 degrees. And rainfall also 8.5 in September, driest month October and November. Okay, see, now answer the question by seeing graphs and table. First one, what are the warmest and coldest months in Leh? Observe the picture. What are the warmest and coldest months in Leh? From the graph, we came to know that June is the warmest month and December is the coldest month in Leh. Right? From the graph, we came to know that June is the warmest month and December is the coldest month. From the range of temperature in the above table, say whether Jaipur is in general hotter than Leh. See here, the place Jaipur lies in Rajasthan. We know that Rajasthan is a desert place, right? So the temperature of Rajasthan is high. Obviously, the temperature of Jaipur is also high, right? See, the place Jaipur lies in Rajasthan. We know that Rajasthan is a desert area, so the temperature of Rajasthan is high. Obviously, the temperature of Jaipur is also high. And Leh is located in Jammu and Kashmir, right? So the temperature of Leh is low compared to Jaipur. See here the comparison, Leh and Jaipur. Now we'll go for Delhi. Delhi lies in northern portion of India, which is bounded by the Himalayas, right? Delhi lies in northern portion of India, which is bounded by the Himalayas. So Delhi experiences wide variations in temperature, whereas Chennai lies in southern portion of India, right, which is near to the Coromandel coast of the Bay of Bengal. See, Chennai lies in southern portion of India, which is near to the Coromandel coast of the Bay of Bengal. So due to its location near equator, it experiences hot and humidity in all three major seasons. Due to its location near equator, it experiences hot and humidity in all three major seasons. Due to its location near equator, it experiences hot and humidity in all three major seasons. So Chennai does not experience extreme variations in temperature. In Chennai, the rainfall is high in October and November months, but there is a less rainfall in Jaipur during the months of October and November. In Chennai, the rainfall is high in October and November months, but there is a less rainfall in Jaipur during the months of October and November. Why? The desert place, Jaipur is located in desert place, right? This variation is due to the place they located. Chennai is located in coastal area and Jaipur is located in desert area, right? See, Jaipur. Next, coastal area. In coastal area, rainfall is heavy compared to desert areas, right? Now we'll go for latitude or distance from the equator. See here, the average temperature for the year drop as we go further away from the equator. The average temperature for the year drop as we go further away from the equator. For this reason, we divide the regions on Earth as tropical region, as though close to the equator, right? Tropical region as those close to the equator. Polar region as those close to the poles, right? Temperate as those in between these two extremes. See, temperate as those in between these two extremes, tropical region and polar region. We have already read about latitude in our previous class. Latitudes are imaginary lines on the Earth's surface that all are of equal distance north or south of the equator. Right? Equal distance north or south of the equators. Lines of latitude are circles on the surface of the Earth. The angle at which sunlight strikes the Earth, which varies by location. See here. ఇక్కడ ఈక్వేటర్ లైన్ దగ్గర సన్ రేస్ చూడండి దగ్గరగా పడుతున్నాయి. అలానే నార్త్ కానీ సౌత్ పోల్ దగ్గర కానీ అక్కడ వెళ్ళండి స్లైట్లీ రైట్. టైమ్ ఆఫ్ డే అండ్ సీజన్ ఈజ్ ఎ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ ఇన్ ద అమౌంట్ హీట్ ఎనర్జీ రిసీవ్డ్ అట్ ఎనీ లొకేషన్ ఆన్ ద గ్లోబ్, thus determining the climate of a region. Time of day and season is a important factor in the amount of heat energy received at any location on the globe, thus determining the climate of a region. The temperature is more intense in the low latitudes than in the high latitudes. As we move away from the equator towards the poles, the average annual temperature decreases. Enduku sunrises sunrise vachi equator line daggara ekku padtayi, adhe నార్త్ పోల్ దగ్గర కానీ సౌత్ పోల్ దగ్గర కానీ వెళ్ళేటప్పటికి తక్కువగా పడుతుంది కాబట్టి టెంపరేచర్ అనేది డిక్రీజ్ అవుతూ ఉంటుంది. ఇన్ ఇండియా ద సౌతర్న్ పార్ట్ లైస్ ఇన్ ద ట్రాపికల్ బెల్ట్ క్లోజర్ టు ద ఈక్వేటర్ అంతేనా. ఇన్ ఇండియా ద సౌతర్న్ పార్ట్ లైస్ ఇన్ ద ట్రాపికల్ బెల్ట్ క్లోజర్ టు ద equator. So this region has higher average temperature than the northern part. This is one reason for climate of Kanyakumari being entirely different from Bhopal or Delhi. India is situated roughly between 8 degrees and 37 degrees north latitudes, and the Tropic of Cancer divides the country into almost two equal parts, right? 23 and a half Tropic of Cancer divides the country into almost two equal parts, northern part and southern part. India is situated roughly between 8 degrees to 37 degrees north latitudes, right? The part south of the Tropic of Cancer lies in the tropical zone. జీరో డిగ్రీస్ నుంచి 23 and a half ట్రాపిక్ ఆఫ్ క్యాన్సర్ మధ్య ఉండే లాటిట్యూడ్స్ అంతా ఆ నార్త్ ప్లేస్ కానీ లేకపోతే సదరన్ పార్ట్ కానీ రెండు ట్రాపికల్ జోన్లోకి వస్తాయి. ట్రాపిక్ ఆఫ్ క్యాన్సర్, ట్రాపికల్ ఆఫ్ కాప్రికాన్, ఈ రెండింటి మధ్య ఉండే లాటిట్యూడ్స్ అన్నీ ట్రాపికల్ జోన్ కిందకి వస్తాయి. ఇక్కడ ఎక్కువ సూర్యరశ్మి గ్రహించడం వల్ల సన్ రేస్ ఎక్కువ స్ట్రైట్గా పడడం వల్ల సన్ అక్కడికే రొటేట్ అవడం వల్ల మన ఎర్త్ రొటేట్ అవడం వల్ల ఎక్కువగా టెంపరేచర్ ఎక్కువ ఉంటుంది. The part north of the Tropic of Cancer lies in the temperate zone. Look at a map of India showing land cover and water bodies, and we will see another important factor which has an influence on climate, that is the land and water relationship. మన ఇండియాకి వెస్టర్న్ సైడ్ అరేబియన్ సీ, ఈస్టర్న్ సైడ్ బే ఆఫ్ బెంగాల్ ఉంది. కాబట్టి పైన హిమాలయాస్ ఉన్నాయి, అందువల్ల which has an influence on climate, that is the land and water relationship. See, the amount of sunlight that is first absorbed and then radiated back or directly reflected depends on the nature of the surface. The amount of sunlight that is first absorbed and then radiated back or directly reflected depends on the nature of the surface. Darker areas such as heavily vegetated regions tend to be good absorbers, and light areas such as snow and ice covered regions tend to be good reflectors, right? See, there is snow. Darker areas such as heavily vegetated regions tend to be good absorbers, and light areas such as snow and ice covered regions tend to be good reflectors. This is ice covered region. Water absorbs and loses heat more fastly than land. Land tondaraga vediki tondaraga challaga avutundi. Ade water ki vachinappudiki water sea level gaani sea water gaani edaina sa water aithe late ga heat aitundi late ga చల్లబడుతుంది. వాటర్ అబ్జార్బ్స్ అండ్ లాసెస్ హీట్ మోర్ ఫాస్ట్లీ దాన్ ల్యాండ్. దిస్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ క్లైమేట్ ఇన్ మెనీ వేస్. వన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ల్యాండ్ అండ్ సీ బ్రీజెస్. సీ బ్రీజెస్ a large part of southern India, southern India, because of its long coastline, comes under the moderating influence of the sea. Right? As says, the difference between the temperature of the day and night and that of summer and winter is not much. This is known as equable climate. Summer and winter.